to life in Egypt. Most noticeable is the landscape. Most noticeable are the changes that extended to the landscape of bilateral international relations. For nations which enjoyed close ties with Egypt are now at a distance, and others who were far are enjoying a stronger relation. These changes will sooner or later find itself mirrored in the trade to seek new opportunities in rising markets and to extend new bridges of cooperation. Contributing towards enhancing the bilateral relation between Egypt and Canada and increasing Canadian investment in Egypt, and due to the fact that we were able to achieve our goals effectively, we were entitled to be one of the most active business organizations in Egypt, which led to being approached by several entities, organizations, and embassies, suggesting cooperation in similar formats where mutual business relations may offer maximum returns to the sharing parties. From here, the initiative originated from our board of directors, who had the desire to participate in building this nation and who believe that the challenges of the current stage make it imperative for us to find creative solutions to help develop the economy and to get the wheel of production turning. In this context, we are pleased to announce the launch of the Egyptian Council for Sustainable Development, through which we can cooperate with all countries, especially those which do not have joint business council with Egypt. This newborn council aims at opening international market before the Egyptian products through organizing and promotional missions and holding meetings and events. Also, the council is in the process of organizing three business trade missions. The first to Central America, co-organized by the Embassy of the Dominican Republic. The second will take place in East Europe, co-organized by the Embassy of Georgia. And the third will target West Europe, co-organized by the Embassy of Portugal. A very warm thanks for all these embassies and the respectable ambassadors for the serious efforts and the trust they have put in our newly established council. Ladies and gentlemen, there is a saying, it's not important to just create opportunities. What's important is to how to make use of them. And since the idea is now created, challenges will compel us to make the utmost use of it. And now, ladies and gentlemen, before I introduce our distinguished guest speaker, I would like to thank my colleagues, the board members who I have the honor to serve with, and by alphabetical order, Engineer Amra Abu Alam, Chairman Lotus Raya Management and Consulting, Dr. Afat Sadat, Chairman Sadat Group, Mr. Hassan Hussein, Chairman Al-Ta'amir for Mortgage Finance Al-Ula, Mr. Khaled Hijazi, External Affairs Director, Vodafone Egypt, Madam Lula Zahlama, President, Tarada Research and Public Relations, Mr. Magid Al-Minshawi, Chairman MENA Pharma, Engineer Mina Morris, Chairman Epcot for Development and Tourism, Mr. Saeed Al-Dirain, General Manager and Partner, TAM Oil Field Service, Engineer Samir Al-Alayli, Managing Director and Partner, Investia Venture Capital, Mrs. Shaira Zaid, Chairman, MZ Investment Company, Dr. Sharif Al-Gabali, Chairman, Polycell Group, and Engineer Yasser Al-Adi, Country Manager of HP. I salute them all for the effort they have exerted in forming and establishing this council. Allow me now to welcome our distinguished guest and a noted politician, His Excellency Minister Nabil Fahmy, Minister of Foreign Affairs, whom as well is a dear friend and an old schoolmate. I recall him as a brilliant school, a student showing early signs of leadership was symbolized by being chosen as the head boy of our school. It's obvious that Minister Fahmy has been called for responsibility at a very difficult time, and we really appreciate his efforts to portray the real picture of Egypt transmitted in this transmission period to the whole world. Mr. Nabi Fahmy.
Thank you, Montez. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you all for being here. I'd like to express my appreciation to the Egyptian Canadian Business Council for your kind invitation to say a few words this evening. I'm not going to give a speech. I know there are several ministers here as well who will also have some comments to make. Some of them are probably more relevant to your work directly. What I'd like to do, however, is commend you for your efforts, that the Business Council continued to be active over the last 3 years. I have followed its work as a reflection of your commitment to this great country. It's also a reflection of your understanding of the economic potential that exists here, which will definitely flourish as things settle more and more in the months and years to come. There are two additional reasons why I'd like to refer to, and I'm very happy to be here. One of them is the fact that you've created this new council on sustainable development. That it's not simply a traditional effort to increase trade or to develop transactions between interested business partners, but in fact, an understanding of what the real challenges are over the next few years. Years back, we had reasonably strong economic growth, but at the same time, we had significant problems with ensuring that that growth reached different levels of our society. And it's something which this government in particular is looking at very carefully. Another point to take into account is that for development to really have an effect on societies, one has to deal with it in a more comprehensive fashion. Not simply matter of figures, but dealing with the issues that change how societies deal with their economic prospects. In this respect, as most of the companies here know, one of the major issues that has been problematic here in Egypt has been energy resources. Trying to provide enough energy to ensure not only that Egyptians have enough power, but also the Egyptian economy has enough power to develop new industries. And this government, presently now in Egypt, is looking seriously at how to use different sources of energy to ensure renewable energy sources. And we're doing that with different partners, and I'm very happy that you're focusing on this as well. I would add also that as we look at the immediate problems that the economy faces because of the slowdown of the economy in the last 3 years, we're also looking at the long-term implications of our decisions. In other words, we're not trying to buy a solution to today's problems at the expense of the future of this country. While we have announced two economic tranches of about £60 billion to help provide liquidity to the economy, we are also planning in the medium and long term with significant commitments in terms of health services, education, environmental projects, creating a better business environment, and also tourism, which is a natural source of income, which of course readily faced a tragedy yesterday. My second reason for applauding you is in fact you helping not only Egypt, but my ministry in particular. Over the last few months, I have made repeated visits to small countries in Africa and also in Asia, and to Latin America, but ultimately I will make that step as well. And the conclusion I draw is that our political relations can only be sustained by true investments by Egypt in many different international communities. And frankly, the Egyptian government doesn't have the resources to do that. It will be done fundamentally by the private sector. One of the tools to achieve that objective is to create business councils between Egyptian companies and respective foreign companies. And while that may be possible between Egypt and Canada, or between Egypt and the US, between Egypt and the EU, it's not always possible with smaller countries, particularly if we're looking at African countries, or even smaller European countries. So the protocol you're signing today, creating a foundation for cooperation and services to different countries here in Egypt to engage the private sector with our private sector here, is a very good idea. It reflects an understanding of the opportunities that exist in these countries and also the challenges that we face. And as I said, it also helps a lot of what we're trying to do with the foreign ministry. Let me close by simply saying there is no real way we can reach the growth levels we want to achieve unless we maximize our value added, take advantage of the potential where it exists, and deal with different trade groups. In fact, 2 days from now, I will be leading to East Africa to a trip to the COMESA summit and a trip to East African countries. And before I do that, I always made a point of consulting with Egyptian businesses that have interest in those countries. This is what I did when I went to West Africa in the past. And frankly, the presence of Egyptian companies in Senegal or in Uganda and Burundi was an eye-opener for me. It also was a very successful introduction into the business systems there. I can see at least two, if not three, ministers out in the among you in the audience. I don't want to consequently speak for too long, but I'm simply again thank Mr. Gassan for the kind invitation. As he said, I've known him for many, many years, although he's not only taller than I am, he's also younger than I am. But he's a good friend and a sense of family. Thank you all for being here. Have a good evening.
Minister of Investment, whom I got to know since a long time from the private sector field, then later as the chairman of the Investment Authority, then as Egypt's Minister of Investment. I have to express our appreciation for the continuous support he provided us with through the past years. So, sir.
Excellencies, ministers, ambassadors, honorable guests, it's a pleasure to be here today attending the launching of the Egyptian Council for Sustainable Growth and Development. In fact, every day we see new things happening in Egypt, really represents a new milestone in our historical times right now in Egypt. The political scene has been developing during the last 6 months. In fact, our roadmap has even developed further by finalizing the constitution with the results that exceeded 97% to 98%. Right now we're going through a new transition where we're going through the presidential election and finally we'll go through the parliamentary elections. At the same time, we have our economic roadmap as well. The situation after June 30th was very critical. A lot of challenges were there for this government to face. Budget deficit exceeding for 13%, 13.7%, unemployment growing, poverty increasing, as well as foreign reserves reducing to a level that really needed to be considered. Our roadmap had really made a lot of improvement during the past 7 months. Our main pillar was how to deal with the pressing and the most important issues that were affecting the Egyptians. In fact, a lot of decisions were taken, and on the top of them were how to reduce the burden on the Egyptians during these very challenging times. On the second pillar, it was how to make this economy recover very quickly. And we started by having our stimulus package, our first stimulus package, so that we can push the economy forward through pushing and increasing more public investments. Third pillar, in fact, this is what's really has to do with the investment. It's how to improve and develop new economic laws that can really put the foundation and set the foundation for a new Egypt. Lot of challenges. We have went through a lot of laws that needed to be revised. Some of them were even. Right now we're working on the new investment law, which will include a lot of changes. More securities will be provided to all the investors. More commitment to all government contractual agreements. And in fact, some cases, we will be finding a new way how to deal with the previous problems that we were left by after the revolution. On the way going forward, I believe that this government has laid a lot of foundation for the coming development. I am very optimistic on how things will go during the coming months. Let me conclude by wishing you a successful council that will help in creating more bridges between countries to create more business, more exchange of experiences, and in fact, more trade and more flourish to our countries. Enjoy your evening and thank you very much.
Last but not least, Minister Hisham Zazour, due to the unfortunate incident that happened in Taba, maybe he would not be able to do it tonight. But would like to welcome His Excellency Minister Ahmed Al-Burai, whom I call a man hard to find in such a tough time, and indeed we have assurance that he adds to the title of the Minister of Social Solidarity in terms of holding this tough responsibility at a time less than a supportive environment. Al-Wazir Al-Burai.
هذه الليلة على المجيء أولاً بتقدم بالشكر للمهندس معتز الأسلام ومجلس الإدارة كله بتاع مجلس الأعمال المصري الكندي للتنمية المستدامة. في حقيقة الأمر بأحيي من سبقوني السيد وزير الخارجية والسيد وزير الاستثمار على كلمتهم المتعلقة بمصر وتأكيدهم على أن الحكومة الحالية تسير في طريقها إلى تحقيق خارطة الطريق. وأود أن أتوجه هذا اليوم بحديثي لهذا المجلس الذي سمي المجلس المصري الكندي للتنمية المستدامة، وأنا أتناول من الاسم فكرة المستدامة. في حقيقة الأمر أنه يجب، وأعتقد أنه لكي تتحقق التنمية الاقتصادية في مصر في المرحلة القادمة، فإننا يجب أن نذكر أول ما نذكر السادة رجال الأعمال جميعاً، الأعضاء في هذه الجمعية الجديدة أو غيرهم، أن هذه التنمية لا يمكن أن تتم من الناحية الاقتصادية فقط. ويجب أن ننبه أن ما حدث في مصر ليس ثورة سياسية فحسب، إنما هي ثورة سياسية وثورة اجتماعية في آن واحد. وأما فكرة المستدامة كنت أود لو أنها قيلت بأنها ليست فقط مستدامة وإنما أيضا شاملة، فقد تعودنا في الأنظمة التي أسقطها الشعب المصري في ثورتين 25 يناير و 30 يونيو، تعودنا أن التنمية قاصرة على الجانب الاقتصادي، ومصر كانت تحقق معدل من التنمية جيد. في 2007 مصر بلغ درجة التنمية فيها 6.8، السيء في مصر كان في حينه هو طريقة التوزيع، ويجب أن نأخذ هذا في الاعتبار. لذلك فإن ثورة 25 يناير و 30 يونيو قررت أن من بين الأهداف الرئيسية لها العدالة الاجتماعية. أود أن أنقل هذه الرسالة العاجلة وأن أنبه مسؤولية رجال الأعمال ليس فقط عن التنمية الاقتصادية وإنما أيضا عن التنمية البشرية. وأود أن أنبه أيضا أن هذه المسؤولية تقع في نطاق ما عرفه الغرب والدول الصناعية الكبرى من المسؤولية الاجتماعية لرجال الأعمال. ويجب أن أقول أيضا أن هذه التنمية البشرية ليست منحة إنما هي وسيلة لزيادة الإنتاج وتقدم الاقتصاد. أرجو أن تكون كلمتي مسموعة، فلن يحدث في مصر بعد الآن تنمية اقتصادية إلا بمراعاة التنمية الاجتماعية. شكرا جزيلا لهذه المرحلة.